Voters in Iran will elect a new parliament this week amid major tensions at home and abroad. Early indications suggest turnout might be low, which poses a problem for the Islamic Republic, which has always based its legitimacy on what it says is the will of the people. Analysts say this year's election is not representative because moderate and reformist candidates have been sidelined. What this means is that hardliners are expected to be the big winners. The result of this week's elections could be an indicator of the outcome of next year's presidential election.
If a hardline government is in charge, any prospect of rapprochement between Iran and the US would look bleak.
So, how did we get here? The US withdrawal from the nuclear deal meant sanctions were reimposed, which had a massive impact on Iran's economy. It also strengthened the position of the hardliners, who felt vindicated in their mistrust of America. Even before the sanctions, mismanagement and corruption meant the country was under huge financial strain. Last year, protests that broke out after petrol prices doubled overnight were brutally suppressed, increasing anger with the government. The US assassination of General Qasem Soleimani in January catapulted the two countries to the brink of war. Iran struck back by targeting US soldiers at an Iraqi airbase. Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei described the strikes as a slap. That slap, however, had repercussions. Anticipating a further US response, a Ukrainian passenger plane was misidentified as a missile and shot down, killing all on board. It took 3 days for the government to admit their error, sending people back onto the streets in protest. Finally, there is the issue of candidates, or lack thereof. Iran's hardline vetting body, the Guardian Council, has rejected 20% of applications to stand in the elections, most of whom happen to be reformists or moderates close to President Rouhani. So, with the prospect of a hardline parliament and a more conservative government, it's likely that tensions with the West will rise.